this reworked bow's finished now. It's had a couple of coats of Danish oil. It'll have a beeswax polish on it before it gets shipped out. Having shot it on Sunday, I probably put about 30 arrows through it, and I was struggling a bit because I hadn't shot for a while, so I was probably only getting it to 29 inch draw. But I checked it on the tiller and it was still that bit overweight. It was about 85 at 30, so I thought, let's have a go at it. I just put the farriers rasp down the belly using the coarse side, just you know, fairly lightly, but right down all along the belly. Cleaned it all up, scraped it back on the tiller, and I could feel just stringing it that it had eased off a tad, just that bit smoother, bit nicer, and I think we're spot on now. Because the guy actually asked for 80 at 30, 31. Well, that's, you know, is it 30 or is it 31? So, do I pull it to 30 and a half? Thing to do would be to pull it to 80 and see what the draw length is. But there's a risk you'd overdraw it. It's hard sometimes to watch draw weight and draw length simultaneously, which is why I have my maximum poundage indicating little thing that I added to that scale. It didn't come with that. It's on my blog somewhere how I made that. But it's very handy. It means I can keep a tight eye on the draw length and it will register the maximum draw weight. Anyhow, enough leathering on. Let's pull it. There you are. I took that to, I think that was 30 and a half, and it's just a whisker. It's about 82, 81, so that's very nice. Really pleased with that. In fact, now I was struggling on Sunday, but I just took it out sour side now, and I could feel I could get over the hump, that last bit of draw. Because with a target draw, where you pull straight, you're pulling the actual full draw weight. With a sort of warbow style draw, you get the elbow higher, and then it comes round and down, and you get this big long arc of movement. So you get sort of 9 inches of movement for 3 inches of draw, so you're getting 3-to-1 leverage. You can get over that hump, but if the bow's too heavy, you get to there and you just can't do it. And you'll hear people say, no, I think the bow's stacking. No, it's not the bow stack, it's their stacking, they just can't. But a lot of it's sort of practice and feel, and if you're warmed up and if you've got the confidence. If you don't think you can do it, you ain't gonna do it. You've got to know you can. Like a lot of things in life. Enough philosophy for now. Hopefully that will get shipped out. Might make it for Friday, might be Monday.